top of a gorge, a narrow opening cut by the action of moving water, forming steep walls made up of soil and rock.
At our last learning circle, we talked about how gravity pulls water downhill,
causing our raindrop to combine with others to form small tributaries that flow down through our watershed.
Sometimes, the shape of the land can cause water to slow down, and at other times, it can be caused by the activity of animals, like beavers, or even us humans.
And as water slows its downward path, it has time to collect into a lake, creating its own unique ecosystem within our watershed.
An ecosystem is a geographic area where plants, animals, and other organisms, as well as weather and landscape, work together to form a bubble of life, containing biotic, or living parts, as well as abiotic, or non-living parts.
It's a place where the activities of all creatures that live there interconnect with the lives of others in their community.
Balance is the key word here. Without balance, we have a system that's unhealthy or not working like it should. Breathe with me, Ava.
Thanks for that balance break, Alder.
Not only is water essential for all life on Earth, it's one of the most powerful forces on the planet. In this place, water has come together from many sources, acting like a giant liquid knife, cutting right through this dense formation of soil and rock.
Geologic features on the surface of the planet, like Cascade Head, are constantly being built up and worn down by two major forces.
Constructive force, which builds up features on the surface of the Earth, pushing up from below or from the deposition of sediment on Earth's surface or ocean floor.
And destructive force, which destroys and breaks down features on Earth's surface, wearing them down and washing them away.
If it weren't for this balancing act between the various forms of water and solids, like soil and rocks, the surface of the Earth would be 100% water.
Again, it's all about balance.
Water is constantly moving and changing the land, every minute of every day, shaping and reshaping it very slowly, over millions of years.
The most common causes of these changes is weathering, from exposure to rain, wind, snow, and ice, erosion, from the flow of water, under the force of gravity, and earthquakes, which break up the surface of the Earth.
Here at this gorge, we see clear evidence of destructive force. Layers of soil and rock being worn away and pushed along by streams, creeks, and rivers. These elements are tumbled and rolled along, breaking apart and becoming smaller and smaller, as they travel with our raindrop back to the sea, where they eventually end up as sand.
Very tiny rocks indeed. Say, we're getting closer to where our raindrop will be mixing with the salty water of the ocean. Bet we'll definitely find some amazing creatures there.
The creatures that live there have made some very special adaptations.
Whoa, just a sec. Adaptation?
Adaptation means a characteristic that helps a species survive and reproduce. In this environment, animals have some pretty special adaptations.
Go on.
Under these conditions, animals have the unique ability to deal with dramatic changes in water conditions, from fresh to salty.
Right, and I think I know one of the very creatures we might find there.
All right, but maybe don't spill the beans until we get there, okay?
Okay, but can I give the people a hint?
Sure.
Can you say anadromous?
Anadromous. And we're going to the very place where we'll see evidence of this adaptation.
I can't wait to see what we'll find there.